If you have been baking homemade bread, then you probably have run into the problem where you don't want to store it in plastic bags because, well, it's plastic, it's not very reusable, and most of us who are trying to move towards a more natural home and or homestead are trying to avoid using things like plastic. However, you also run into the issue with homemade bread. Because we don't have the preservatives in it, hallelujah, that most store-bought bread does, it tends to mold a lot faster. So we run into this conundrum of trying to keep our fresh bread nice and fresh without letting it go moldy, but also avoiding the plastic. So you've got a couple of different options if you're trying to avoid the plastic. One is using a bread box, but they are larger, this one especially. This one is metal and it has some compartments and shelves up here on top, or I should say drawers, not shelves. They also make wooden bread boxes, but those take up quite a bit more space and they don't really protect the bread that much from drying out. So our other two options are bread bags. Now you've got 100% cotton, which is what this tea towel is made out of, and I also have used 100% cotton bread bags in the past, or you have linen. So these are 100% linen bread bags. The difference between the cotton and the linen is actually, for me, has been quite a big difference as far as the shelf life of the bread. Now, both cotton and linen will allow it to breathe, which is really good in helping to avoid mold. The plastic, while it does keep bread moist, unfortunately tends to get moldy oftentimes within just a few days. When I've used the cotton bread bags and the linen bread bags, I don't get any mold. However, the cotton bread bag, while cotton fabric is usually less expensive because you don't have to wait as long or go through as much of a process in order to use cotton when it's been harvested, it is breathable, but it tends to dry out faster, at least in my experience. So even though I didn't have mold issues, if we didn't eat the bread within 1 or 2 days, then it started to get really dried out. And I don't know about you, but I don't really like my bread to be super dry. I like it to be moist. So then I had a combination fabric that was part linen and part cotton, and that was a little bit better, but I still wasn't really happy with the shelf life of the bread. Then I got the 100% linen, and this was, for me, a game changer. It does depend on the type of bread. So where it has that crunchy outer crust, but the soft center, this is the type of loaf that the linen bread bag is ideal for. I can put this bread in this and have it last for 6 days, no mold whatsoever. Now where it's cut, it will dry out, but if I just cut off the open end, right, where it's been exposed to the air, and just cut that off within just like one slice in, it's still nice and soft in the center. Now, as I near the 6th day, it is starting to dry out a little bit. And by the 7th day, it was too hard to really cut through. I only had a small little end piece left. So by the 7th day, then it's great because it's so dry. If you want to turn it into homemade croutons or breadcrumbs, you're already well on your way. Now, if you're doing something that's softer though, like an enriched bread or a sandwich bread, 1 to 2 days, and then it does start to dry out faster because it doesn't have that crunchy outer crust to help keep the moisture out. So at that point, then I will slice what is ever left of the sandwich loaf if we haven't ate it by that 2nd day. And then I freeze that, and then I just pull out a slice at a time and pop it in our toaster, and it will thaw it really quick without toasting it from that frozen state, and it tastes completely fresh. Oftentimes people will ask me about storing their bread in the fridge. You actually don't want to do that because it makes it stale and it shortens the shelf life. So it seems like it would be the opposite, that it would stop mold from happening. But I have not found using it for like sandwich breads or loaves like this, for quick breads where it has a lot of fruit and it has a lot more higher moisture content, sugar content, etc. That's been okay. But ideally, you want to keep these at room temperature. So you do have a couple of options. One, this was just baked. It's still just slightly warm. You do want it to get all the way fully cool before restoring it, but this is breathing, so it's not quite like a plastic. You definitely need to make sure it's fully cooled before you ever store bread in plastic. But hopefully after watching this, you will be getting yourself a linen bread bag. So obviously I can just put this entire loaf. There's no place that's been cut, so I can put this in here and it will store beautifully. This has the drawstrings, so I just like to pull this nice and tight, and then I will just put it underneath like that, and there it will store on the shelf, on the counter, on the table, wherever it is that you want to, until you're ready to serve it. And you can see this is long enough that you could even do baguettes, or if you had a larger loaf, this is a pretty good sized loaf, you're still going to be able to get that in there and fit it. So once you are ready to cut your loaf, I like to go right in the center here. Listen to that crunchy crust. Now you've got a couple of options. Most people prefer to cut it in the center and then slice off whatever it is you're going to be using. This is lunch today. And now I'm gonna fit these two cut pieces back together. That's gonna help them from drying out quite as fast, unless, like if I had just cut this where you had a completely exposed edge. So that is going to help, and then we're just gonna put that right back into our bread bag, seal that up, and go under like this. And there you go. The great thing is these are completely washable. We can wash them a lot, and I have not had any issues with mold since switching over to these. With the linen, I do wash them in the washing machine, and then I just let them line dry. Linen does tend to wrinkle more than cotton, but honestly, I don't really care if my linen bread bag has some wrinkles. If wrinkles drive you crazy, feel free to iron it. The linen bread bags are ideal for the harder crusted breads, but they also work really well for storing items like biscuits and rolls, especially things like sourdough baguettes and English muffins. If you want to get some of these linen bread bags, we do have them in the shop over at melissaknorris.com. There'll be a link below in the video. And if you want to get your hands on this bread recipe, you can go and check that out and get a printable copy right here.